There's a way to stop the spread of coronavirus. There's a way to protect others. There's a way to keep your family safe. New York figured it out. The answer weighs less than an ounce. It's not a heavy lift. Be New York tough. Mask up, America.
Welcome here. It has been a fun day for me as I've been playing Let's See What Allergy Medicine Works, but we are here for some Frisco League basketball as the Bulldogs host the Hornets, and we will turn it over to the announcer for the introductions. We are here. The Bulldogs, once again, are hosting the Hornets for a Frisco League contest. I do not know the records for either of these teams. To be truthful, I did not get the records for these teams ahead of time. We are ready to begin. We do have a special camera for tonight. This is our sideline camera, so this will switch sides with Dixon. And Bulldogs will figure out where my scoreboard control order is. It's on the wrong side. And Lakeway gets a hand in there to get a hold of the ball. Lakeway had a good showing in the Richland tournament earlier. And Dixon gets their chance. A little sloppiness from both teams. Both teams are having trouble getting to the rim right now. I just realized a small problem with my sideline camera over there. So we're going to have a first turnover of the game, so first minute gone, and no points so far. Good opportunity for Dixon. Good pass underneath, able to hang on to it, but missed the first, missed the second. Offensive rebound. Once again, reverse pass, still not there. We have Dixon's the first one to score as neither team was able to really get much on it there. Did not run at all there, but another minute has gone by. 4:04 remains. I'm having the triangle issue already. I hope that resolves itself quickly. YouTube is usually pretty good about that. Dixon wearing the black, or Lakeway in black, Dixon in the white. There's our sideline camera there. And Dixon will earn a couple free throws off that. Like number three comes in for number one of the Hornets. Fix my cable issue. I believe I fixed it. My cables come loose to my camera a couple times. Dixon looking for a cut underneath. It's going to be a foul against Dixon. And I've got some odd numbers coming here. Let me see. I'm still going here. Dixon will add to their lead. Dixon leads 5 points. I was right. And another shot, not there. And it has some free throws coming for the Bulldogs here. I gotta fix my camera here. So I don't have that issue of it binding up. I think I have it fixed. First free throw was no good. Second one was good. I believe it's a cable causing the black. I think I fixed it. I did. For now at least. And we are rolling now, so wait. Court pressed by the Hornets. And keeping up the clock very well here, I apologize. It's going to be, I believe, the second foul on 25. By Lakeway. Oh, Hornets. Hey, one more. Lakeway had some good three-point shots earlier as some couple of close shots there, and Dixon gets the rebound going the other way. Dixon, that three is going to be off target, so 1:05 remaining. We got several subs coming in. I'm going to fix the camera. And blocked by the Bulldogs. Much different ball game than earlier that we had. We'll have those highlights coming to you at halftime. Out and last off of Lakeway, so and we have a foul against Dixon, so Dixon's really collecting the fouls here. 17 seconds in the first quarter. We'll be bringing you most of the home games for volleyball and basketball now. Do not know tomorrow's plan, but Lakeway hits that three as the clock runs out. So we'll be back after this 1 minute PSA.
There's a lot of fear in coming back to school. I wasn't sure if I could do it. I'm a 40-year-old man that walked in there to get his high school diploma. It was very hard for me, but the teachers, the counselors, they help you. One of the teachers was Ms. Araceli. Ms. Araceli, she gave me direction. Every single time I had a question, she'll put down whatever she's doing and she'll come over and she'll sit there with you until you get it.
Thank you, Ms. Araceli. I know you make a difference in people's lives because of the person and teacher you are. I wanted to be here because I wanted to thank you for helping me get a beautiful gift.
50% of getting your high school diploma is walking through those doors. The other 50% is doing the work. Getting your high school diploma, it is a life-changing experience. It really is.
Find free adult education classes near you at finishyourdiploma.org.
So, coming out of the break, the Hornets are coming up. This is our courtside camera here. An inadvertent buzzer, which not sure what the buzzer was. Give me time to start my clock, which I didn't start. We're going to have a foul called against Dixon again, I believe it is. And another foul. Nope, that'll be out of bounds on the Hornets, so Lakeway is coached by Steve Schofield and his son. Steve Schofield was a former Bulldogs coach last year. And the Dixon Bulldogs were coached by Logan Ray, who was the Newburgh Wolves coach last year. So both these coaches know each other very well. And Schofield's son, who is currently coaching right now, that's Brad Schofield. Dixon gets in double digits first as I think the clock is right. We're going to have sure about a foul there. The ball kind of came loose. A little bit of contact. So we're going to have a 1-1 as Schofield. This is team of pep talk. The sideline camera will be moving to the other side for the second half. 5:19 remain in the first half. So, Lakeway will pull within four. And pull within one basket. And we're going to have a turnover. That'll be backcourt. So the balls are just seeming a little off stride today. And the change of weather. We've got drastic change of weather. Well, we've had from 40 degrees to 80 degrees the last couple days. Has definitely not cooperated with me. And Dixon, beautiful little shot underneath as he was able to cross underneath the goal to get that. We're going to have a foul turnover on. Foul or turnover, I'm not sure which one it was, but it results in the same thing right there. As another whistle, we got a couple subs coming in. That is my roster here. That is Cole Story coming for Lakeway. The game clock is official, so if mine gets off track, it'll be fixed the next dead ball. And we're going to have a timeout called by Lakeway. We'll be back after this 30-second PSA.
The innocence of youth. Is there anything any better? But soon they'll be in high school and facing all the same challenges you faced. How to make friends. How to fit in. How to be cool. We want our children to have everything they'll need to live fulfilling and productive lives. Make sure the kids in your family are among the more than 290,000 participants here in Missouri who take part in high school sports or activities.
And we are back there. The Bulldogs are finishing their timeout. And from our sideline camera, the Hornets are also finishing their timeout. Lakeway is set for their offense, it looks like. The Bulldogs have a 12-5 lead here. Just a couple baskets can make a big difference. And inbounds nearly under the basket. And good shot. Good job on keeping the ball. Dixon was able to get a hand on that to prevent an easy bucket. And that's going to be out, so it's going to be off Dixon. .401 here in the first half. This has been a pretty quick half. at halftime, we will actually have our pregame, which I forgot to do. A little set play right there as a little two-game action underneath. Drives the sideline, kicks it out, open shot, and we're going to have a whistle blown. We got a jump ball, so Dixon Lakeway should get the ball. Lakeway will get the ball. Another inbounds under the basket. We have a line-type formation, and they go for the safety guy. Wide open three. That's going to be off. Offensive rebound is going to be off. Dixon with the rebound. Dixon had an open three. He's got an open three. He passes underneath. Lakeway gets a hand on it. We'll start unveiling the schedules for both Dixon and Richland, as I will be bringing you most of their games this year. I'll be bringing you the JV and varsity of the high school, along with A and B team and JV and varsity of volleyball. I will be probably doing varsity for Richland. Depends on what time I get off work. Once again, from our sideline camera here, we have second free throw for Dixon. And stolen by Dixon. Shot underneath. And Dixon, another offensive rebound. Dixon gets the shot, so 16-7. And Lakeway in traffic, almost lost the ball. Hornets recover it, but shot's no good. We got about 2 minutes to go, by the way. My And we're going to have another, looks like some more free throws coming. Throws no good. 2:01 remains. So Lakeway with a couple subs. And that free throw is good. And three from the corner, little off target, but that's going to bring up a couple free throws for Lakeway. Hey, 17-7 lead, 147 remains in the first half. And at the line is Cameron Storberg. First free throws off target. Dixon, 18 fouls. Lakeway, 5. Second free throw is good, so with an open three. Dixon hits the open three. First half. Coming into the game is Dominic Sheldon. Offensive set by Dixon as it was Baker underneath for the basket. We have a jump ball, so Bulldogs will get the jump. Open three, off target, rebound Bulldogs, and no one there, so Lakeway will get the ball back. Seconds in the half. Seconds to go. So this may be a one shot for Lakeway, or they may try for shot and then a steal. Long three. That is off target. And with that, that will end the first half. And here is our pregame that was supposed to run. So we'll see you in 10 minutes.
By an invisible villain. There's an elite group helping them understand and be safe. They're fighting what's out there by staying in here. They are the Stay Heroes. Meet the Great Hygienie, expert at washing hands and disinfecting surfaces and objects. Dr. Distancio is a master of physical distancing and virtual playdates. And General Fields uncovers emotions and harnesses positivity. Your kids can become Stay Heroes too. Learn how at stayheroes.org.
Welcome back as we are getting ready for the boys game now. And last week, the Dixon boys, the A team did not struggle at all. It was a 30-point win, and from the beginning to the end, it was a 30-point win. So here's some highlights from the
offensive rebound. Dixon will come back and tie this game right back up. Really settled down and slowed anything down yet as good underneath, offensive rebound, and Dixon takes a 6-2 lead. Good job by the Bulldogs, open from the wing, shots up, offensive rebound, shots in, 8-2 Dixon. off the hands as Dixon drives back in, kicks it up, and Dixon will be the first in double digits. So, and Dixon up, and they are able to score on that beautiful effort. Quick basket, beautiful underscore pass, and Dixon will... Dixon drives, Dixon will score, so Dixon will continue to underneath, and Dixon with a beautiful play. Bulldogs drive underneath, shoot, a little too much, offensive rebound, second offensive rebound, and Dixon, good drive, good shot, and good score for the Bulldogs. Dixon shoots. And he will get the bounce. So we don't have heights here. So Hans is a, we'll say a 6'5 guard. That sounds about right. 3-point shot. 3-point shot is in. That was, especially some of you athletic people, as Dixon will add to their lead. Dixon comes away with it. Passes up the three. Drives in a little. Gets a little bounce, and we have a 29-point game, I believe. Another drive, and good rebound by the Bulldogs. Shot is... So the clock does continue to run, though, as Dixon... And that's a... First one was a miss, rebound, stolen, and that one will connect, so... We will end this, a 45-13 win for the Dixon Bulldogs.
There's a lot of fear in coming back to school. I wasn't sure if I could do it. I'm a 40-year-old man that walked in there to get his high school diploma. It was very hard for me, but the teachers, the counselors, they help you. One of the teachers was Miss Araceli. Miss Araceli, she gave me direction. Every single time I had a question, she'll put down whatever she's doing and she'll come over and she'll sit there with you until you get it.
Thank you, Ms. Araceli. I know you make a difference in people's lives because of the person and teacher you are. I wanted to be here because I wanted to thank you for helping me get a beautiful gift.
50% of getting your high school diploma is walking through those doors. The other 50% is doing the work. Getting your high school diploma, it is a life-changing experience. It really is.
Find free adult education classes near you at finishyourdiploma.org.
We have a matchup between Lakeway and Dixon in the B team, as last week Dixon had an early lead and Plato came back, but Dixon was able to hold on for a 4-point win. And we'll send it back to you, Alan, in the gym, and have a good game and have a safe trip home after.
Dixon, good offense down below. First shot's up. First shot is going to go in. Dixon kicks it in. Thought about the three. Drives instead. Beautiful setup on the pass right there. Second free throw is good. So steal underneath. And a great effort underneath as Dixon was able to score on that. Kramer gets... couple more chances at the line. Beautiful pass by Dixon. We're going to have Newberg is right there to counter it and cut it back to 7. Newberg drives, kicks out, 3-point shot. It is good. 4-point ball game. 3-point shot. That one makes it. So we have a 1-point ball game. 1:35 remains. Thank you. cuts up, not there. Rebound. Offensive rebound, Jacob, and Dixon will. And that is the 4-point difference that the Bulldogs. That is going to be it. That will end the game as beautiful B team game. The Dixon Bulldogs will defeat Newburgh 18-14.
I want to be a meteorologist, a doctor, a chemist. But now I found a new love for space science. I'm planning to be an astrophysicist.
We were told that Ella wasn't talking much at school. Teachers would be like, we don't know if she's understanding us. She's not responding. Then the first grade teacher said that she had some decoding issues. That's being able to sound out word.
So we are coming back here as Bulldogs are getting ready for the second half. There we go. Turn my echo off. We have moved our cam on the other side there. So Lakeway will be first to get possession. Got sub coming in for the Hornets as I am burning the clock down. We are right back on target. And a couple more subs coming in, so now we're ready to roll as Lakeway will be on there in this time. And whistle underneath, so turnover Bulldogs as still have a 22-8 score here in favor of Dixon. Dixon had a late run in the second half to give them a comfortable cushion. 3-point shot for the Hornets, rebound for Dixon. Are thankful to be the broadcaster for the Bulldogs this year. And we have a whistle down low, so we're going to have a shooting foul. It's going to send Storberg to the line. So far, neither team has scored in the second half. Both teams are coming out of halftime cold. And nearly traveled on that, but Dixon, once again, the pass underneath, a couple there, and easy layup for the Bulldogs as I'm going to have to borrow that offense. That's working well. Tomorrow is the first day of registration for the YMCA Basketball League, which I'll have two teams this year. I plan to. Those games will be played in Waynesville. There will be some restrictions, which parents will have to follow by the Waynesville School District, but thankful they are playing basketball. Not sure the number of games yet, but it may be lower than what it's been in the past. But it'll give the kids a chance to go out and the real thing is to learn the basics and just work on their skills. The more time you get to play, the better you can improve. I don't know if we're doing a full B or a half B here. And Bulldogs will. Have a chance to do something here. First shot by Dixon is good. As 52, which is Sheldon will come in and McBride will take a break. And that is good. So second shot was good for Dixon. A turnover, so 26-9. And Bulldogs are starting to get hot now as they're extending their lead a little bit. Good position for Lakeway, but Dixon's there. And we have a, I think it's a turnover on Lakeway. It's going to be a foul. And coming into the game is Isaiah Boggs for the Hornets. He's going to give Matthew Marlowe a rest. Inbounds, Dixon's there to prevent the three. Lakeway takes a three from nearly the top of the key. The Hornets, we got a whistle. That shot is off target as we'll give Lakeway the ball back. We've kind of been trading off scores here, so neither team has really taken advantage of anything or really improved. Both these teams are capable of shooting well. Before the game, Lakeway had several players that were able to hit threes from outside. Good drive, just a little off-balance shot. That's going to go out of bounds and turnover for Dixon. And that's, I believe we got a flag for pass interference out there on that one. As he had contact with the receiver before the ball was able to get to his hands. So it's a 15-yard penalty and first down for the Bulldogs. Shot underneath. Lakeway's there. So turnover for Dixon as kind of a missed opportunity there. We have some contact, but Dixon will come away with the ball. Dixon down low. Dixon with the shot. That's going to be missed. Lakeway the other way. And just short, second attempt is over. Lakeway comes down with it. So 146, we have a timeout. We'll be back after this PSA.
I don't remember how it started. Our back and forth. Victory. Fumble. Repeat. It always came back.
Dad!
Okay, here we go, throw it!
Yeah!
You probably don't remember what you told me.
And we are back after that, as we had an injured player on the court. And free throws, no good. I'm not sure what the 1-1 free throw was, but Dixon with a strong rebound up above. A timeout for the Bulldogs. Will be back after this PSA.
The innocence of youth. Is there anything any better? But soon they'll be in high school and facing all the same challenges you faced. How to make friends. How to fit in. How to be cool. We want our children to have everything they'll need to live fulfilling and productive lives. Make sure the kids in your family are among the more than 290,000 participants here in Missouri who take part in high school sports or activities.
So Dixon is coming out of there, right there, as it was 30-9 in the third quarter. Look for inbounds underneath. Good play. And big man move underneath, as great placement of the ball, and he was ready to go on that. Good three, just a little bit short. Another defensive rebound. And that's going to be too high, so it's going to result in a turnover. We have coming into the game Jesse Tanner for the Hornets. And three from the corner. We have a foul called. And no one touched it, so Dixon ball. So if this keeps up, we will be a running clock the final quarter. So far, the Hornets haven't found a way to stop Dixon, except Dixon has kind of stopped themselves a little bit there. Something you preach about. free throws here. And it's going to result in a turnover for Dixon, but Dixon still leads by 27 points, I believe. Somewhere around that number. I don't have 27 fingers and toes, so I ran out after 20. And we're going to have a defensive foul on the Bulldogs.
What?
34. No shot. Or no shooting shot on there, but. And. So I'll give Dixon final shot for the quarter. And 1 second remains as this is going to be a catch and shoot. And that's got to be a there it is. Before the buzzer, so. With that, we'll be back after signing the PSA. The Bulldogs lead 32-9.
There's a lot of fear in coming back to school. I wasn't sure if I could do it. I'm a 40-year-old man that walked in there to get his high school diploma. It was very hard for me, but the teachers, the counselors, they help you. One of the teachers was Miss Araceli. Miss Araceli, she gave me direction. Every single time I had a question, she'll put down whatever she's doing and she'll come over and she'll sit there with you until you get it.
Thank you, Ms. Araceli. I know you make a difference in people's lives because of the person and teacher you are. I wanted to be here because I wanted to thank you for helping me get a beautiful gift.
50% of getting your high school diploma is walking through those doors. The other 50% is doing the work. Getting your high school diploma, it is a life-changing experience. It really is.
Find free adult education classes near you at finishyourdiploma.org.
So Dixon will get the ball to start the final period of the A game. I don't know if we have a half or a full game coming up for B, so. And that's going to be off. It's going to be off Dixon. So Lakeway will force the turnover to start out. Foul on Lakeway, so an inbounds underneath. And we're going to have a timeout called on the Bulldogs, so we'll be back after this 30-second PSA.
The innocence of youth. Is there anything any better? But soon they'll be in high school and facing all the same challenges you faced. How to make friends. How to fit in. How to be cool. We want our children to have everything they'll need to live fulfilling and productive lives. Make sure the kids in your family are among the more than 290,000 participants here in Missouri who take part in high school sports or activities.
The play is finished coming out. The Bulldogs are finished with their timeout, so we're going to have. I'm curious here. I'm wondering if we're going to do a inbound little hook shot right there. And they try it. Second guy's there. Shot over. And that one's not there. Lakeway, we have a whistle called on that. So that will be against the Bulldogs. Oh, we have shooting a couple shots, so that will give Lakeway a couple opportunities here as Boggs will go to the line. Dixon still leads 32-19 with 5:12 in this ball game. And we have a we got one extra guy out there, I believe. Oh, maybe we got him sorted out. Looks like now we're back to five. We had a platoon substitution there. You guys are good. Second one, couple bounces. Didn't get the right bounce, though. It's in. Lakeway steals it, gets back the other way. And just off the rim. Good shot on that one, though. This is where Dixon just needs to slow down and realize that they have the advantage. I think in about 4 or 5 weeks, we're going to have some new scoreboards, I was told, which would be nice and provide some individual scoring for players. And Dixon wants to get another turnover. They really haven't added much to the offense this final quarter. They kind of stalled out. They need to really just slow down and take your time with what you have right now. You have 4 minutes to go. Just protect the basket, prevent easy shots, and kind of ice this game. And once again, another turnover for the Bulldogs as they're really rushing things, and we have another platoon swap going on for Lakeway. In my opinion, that's the best way to do your best as a team. Get you 10 players and 5 in, 5 out. And off target again. So Dixon really just, they can slow down and not really worry much at this point. They can burn the clock out right there underneath. He's open and almost too strong, but he's able to connect on that shot. I'll be using this game film to form an offense, I believe, after this. Lakeway, he's got two guys there, nearly stolen. Dixon, you don't need to score here. You just have to run this clock down. Good pass underneath. Surprisingly not a foul. And once again, some contact. No foul. So I believe that was a jump ball. Another platoon swap again. So I have done this method to try to stir something up and catch a team off guard before. Sometimes it works, sometimes it don't. Good inbounds, a little too hard. Second time is good. Looks in with a good drive of their own. Just a little bit off, and that's probably going to be a foul on the Bulldogs. Four more points, and Dixon has a 30-point lead in the game. So So the turkey's done, the stuffing's warming up, and we are about ready for dinner here as they're ready to pull out the silverware in this ball game. And another turnover as Dixon is really just having some unforced errors here to close this game out. So, inbounds. Surprised didn't take the three there. That was a good open shot. And with the guy in his face, he does get it up, though. And I believe that is another Baker with the rebound. And another travel by the Bulldogs. So that was Rafin Baker. On that last rebound by the Bulldogs. So both these teams continue to play hard. Both these teams also have a high scoring offense, so playing a little bit of pass and catch out there quite a bit. So that's going to bring up, I believe, some free throws here for Sorberg again. He's had three or four chances at the line, and he's done a decent job. And the one and one was no good. Baker with the shot, and good two-point effort on that. See the other number on the assist, but a good assist also. And turnover on the Hornets, so Dixon's got the ability here to slow this down, and one more score will make this pretty close to 20, I believe, or 30. And good defense by Lakeway, though. They haven't given up as another platoon swap. Multiple of these platoon swaps here, which is kind of catching the Bulldogs off guard. What you really need to do is you have a shooting platoon and you have a big platoon. You could really disrupt another team that way. And ball's still going. It kind of got left on the ground there, fumbled. And he's open. And we're going to have a shooting foul on that. No, we're not. We're going to have a traveling call on that. Wide open three. Will go out. 40 seconds remain. It's still just one basket away, and Lakeway is nowhere near the bonus, so we're going to have a inbounds. Now, if you can get 42, do a little curl right there, you can do a perfect little inbounds play. And that was also a nice play, but a little small for what was going on there. And three, the three goes down. So now we are a running clock. And I believe that will ice the game as dinner is ready to serve. Head to the table, and we'll see you back for dessert after this ball game. As we still have, I guess, 10 seconds on the game clock for some reason. I'm not sure why they stopped the clock earlier. It's 30. Now the club buzzer will ring as that will do it. And final score from Dixon High School, Dixon 41, Lakeway 10. And we will see you back in, I believe, about 10 minutes. Go get you something to drink, get you something to eat, and we'll see you then.
At a time when kids may be confused by an invisible villain, there's an elite group helping them understand and be safe. They're fighting what's out there by staying in here. They are the Stay Heroes. Meet the Great Hygiene, expert at washing hands and disinfecting surfaces and objects. Dr. Distancio is a master of physical distancing and virtual playdates. And General Fields uncovers emotions and harnesses positivity. Your kids can become Stay Heroes too. Learn how at stayheroes.org.